Antonio de Padua Maria Severino Lopez de Santa Anna y Perez de Lebron, better known as Santa Anna, was born in 1794 in the Mexican state of Veracruz. He was born into a wealthy family and was not interested in education. At the age of 16, Santa Anna decided to join the Spanish army. He fought in the Mexican Revolution. He joined the revolution fighting for Spain, but in 1821, his loyalty switched and he fought out the rest of the war for the Mexican army. He rose in the ranks of the Mexican army and used his position to help support Vicente Guerrero, a presidential candidate who came in second. Santa Anna used his military position to invalidate the results of the election, and Guerrero became president. Guerrero rewarded Santa Anna by giving him the top position in the army. In 1833, Santa Anna was elected president of Mexico. At first, the Texans liked Santa Anna because he promised to help out the Texans and be kind to them. But he didn't hold true to his promises, so the Texans did not like him as much. Santa Anna began dictatorship in 1835. At this point, what is now Texas was under the rule of Mexico. In 1825, Santa Anna married his first wife, Inez Garcia. They had four kids, Maria de Guadalupe, Maria del Carmen, Manuel, and Antonio Lopez de Santa Anna y Garcia. 2 months after his first wife died, Santa Anna, when he was 50 years old, married a 16-year-old named Maria de los Doras de Tosta. They did not have any kids together. Lots of people claimed to have a kid with Santa Anna, but only four of those people were true. The four kids that Santa Anna had that were not with his wives were Paula and Maria de la Merced and Petra and Jose Lopez de Santa Anna. The Texas Revolution began in 1835. The first battle was located in Gonzales in the September of 1835. The fight was over a cannon. Texas won that battle. The Texans took over the Alamo and used it as their fort. Santa Anna led the attack on the Alamo in February of 1836. He had a policy of take no prisoners, which basically means that he did not take any hostages, and he killed everyone that he saw. The Texans got massacred, but took out 600 Mexicans for the approximately 200 Texans that were there. This led to the Battle of San Jacinto, where the Texans snuck up on Mexican camp and surprised the entire Mexican army, most of which were napping. The battle lasted 18 minutes, and 700 Mexicans were killed, while only 17 Texans were killed. Santa Anna was taken prisoner when he tried to escape wearing a private's uniform. Texas was then a free nation. Santa Anna lost a lot of his popularity after the Texas Revolution, but in 1838, the French invaded Mexico and Santa Anna fought very hard and heroically for Mexico. They drove out the French, but in the process, Santa Anna lost part of his left leg. This gave him a better reputation for both leading the army to win the battle and fighting very well himself. Later, he held a parade for his left leg and displayed the part lost in the center of Mexico City for everyone to see. He was given lots of the blame for Mexico's loss in the Mexican-American War. The Mexican-American War is a war where the United States fought Mexico over where the boundary between those two countries should be. Santa Anna finally fell out of office in 1853. In his older age, he spent much time in exile. He died on June 21st, 1876, at the age of 82, from natural causes. Today, he is known as a great leader in Mexico, but as an evil person in Texas.